Today's session, we'll talk about. Okay, we'll talk about just. We'll see how to create the accounting calendar. Already discussed about. Okay, what are the key points we have to consider to create the accounting calendar? Right, we discussed. We have to know the which country we are going to create the calendar. For that country, we should understand what is the finance year. Based on that, we can select year type. Then accordingly, what are the period type the required for company accounting transaction process that will be choosing. Based on that, first what we have to create the period type. That we have seen in yesterday's session how to create it. Then based on that, we'll create the accounting calendar. Then we'll see how to enable or create the currencies really required or not. That we'll discuss detail level. Finally, we'll go through this some few points which we have to understand before we go and create the chart of accounts in system. Then once these three are ready, anyway, the fourth C is accounting method. By using those four C's, we'll create the primary ledger. Let's do it. So we'll connect to the server. So which user we are using?
Operations.
Since this is a vision instance, we are using the operations. Later we'll create our own user and everything will be creating, okay, by taking some case, okay, and we'll be working. For now, initially, to create this calendar up to primary ledger and a user creation will depend on these operations. When you are working in real time, this user won't be there because you never work on the vision instance. We'll be working in the fresh environment. In that case, how we have to start with the process that we'll be discussing in the further classes. Okay, done. Username is operations, password is welcome. So now we have to go to which responsibility?
General
Ledger, Vision Operations, USA. Just click on that.
Yes.
Within this responsibility, what we have? Menu. Right? But we cannot see menu from here. Only you can see the menu if you open the responsibilities from the other application called a system administrator. Means wherever you create it, or else in the process of creation of responsibility, only you can see the menu. That we'll see detail level. Okay. So within that menu, we'll be having the submenus and functions. Only submenus and functions you can see under responsibility. Okay. Now just click on any one of the submenu, it will open the functions. Click on any one of the function, it will open the application in form-based environment. Right? This is what we discussed already. Since we selected function called as enter function related forms are open, you can close them. Okay, done. Now in the last session, what we did, we created period type. Just we'll take the navigation, we'll see what we created, then we'll continue with the accounting calendar creation. Navigation is setup, financials, calendars, types. So here we created our period type and you can click on find, or else we can go with the query mode that also we discussed. Here we given the name as HCL monthly. We discussed the point when you are working, generally we don't give that company name as a prefix for the period type creation. Generally you can write monthly. Since this is a kind of demo or test or vision instance, there will be multiple definitions where people will be trying for their practice. To differentiate, we given the company name that will help us to easily identify the period type what we created. Done. Okay. So this is what we created. These period type will be using when you are creating our accounting calendar. Right? We'll be using the time of the definition. Fine, done. So here I'll just will list out what we are going to discuss. Okay, fine. Here we discuss the point. I'll be writing in the separate spreadsheet, but here we are just going to create the accounting calendar So to create the accounting calendar, we have to perform two steps. First one is create
period
type. This is already created. Now we have to create accounting calendar. Say create accounting calendar. As we discussed already, so when you are creating the period type, you take an application as general ledger. That's enough. For each and every task which you do, you don't need to take application is something. If you are going to perform some task in the different application, then you can give the application name as different. If you are going to do in the same application, you don't need to just take a note every time, or else when you are creating the document also, you don't need to write every time application is general ledger or GL. Okay. So now to create the accounting calendar, take the navigation. Take the navigation to create the accounting calendar. Navigation is setup, financials, you know, taking the note also follow the same, okay, way of representation, financials. Then double click on financials, you'll see the calendars. Say calendars. Then here we have a accounting. So earlier we created period type for that, this is a function name. Now we are going to create accounting calendar. We have a function name called as accounting. See here, I'll tell you, just we'll talk about other points. See here, what your function name you can see as a accounting, but the same function name, how system will understand, okay, what name system will consider for this accounting calendar, that if you want to see, you can select it, select to the right top 10 list. So I selected two times. The system is understanding that as a calendar. So here we can go with some shortcut also. At that time, you can use that kind of names. Okay. See, for example, I can select this type also here. Their system is understanding as a period type. So here max, you can add how many?
10
only. What is the advantage? What is the advantage? Generally, setups and all, we don't do very frequently. This top 10 list they are given for the transaction process. Users will be recording the different transactions. Okay, very frequently which transaction they'll be recording to access quickly, they can add those into top 10 list, like something like some favorites kind of thing. Then simply if they click on that, relevant form will open. See, now if I want to open the period type, I no need to go take the navigation since I selected to top 10 list. Okay, what function we have here?
Period type.
I can double click, it will open. That's it. Otherwise, here top 10, right? So this is number is
two.
From keyboard press 2, it will open. That's how you can select. But when you are doing the setups, you don't need to do it. When you are working on the process transaction, you'll be doing the variety of the transaction, okay, by using the same function. In that case, even you can try with this. Now, when you are doing setups, no need to do it. Setups means we'll do one time. For one time, you can take navigation. After taking the navigation, even if you select into this list again, you are not going to use it, right? So you can try this for transaction purpose. I will be discussing that. Okay, I'm just removing this from here. Okay, the navigation is
setup,
financials, calendars, accounting. Fine. I think same navigation we've taken, calendars, accounting. Done. Now double click. Give the calendar name, because this calendar name, okay, got some limitation with the limited characters. We can enter limited characters only to give the name. So always what you can go with the short name, okay, or else you can go with just one word name if possible. Okay, depends. Here just simply I'll give the name as HCL. I'll give HCL accounting ACC. since I am writing the name in short, I mean, since I am writing short name, I am giving all in uppercase. Remember, when you are writing, when you are practicing, also just always make sure that how you should write, how you should not write. Not all in uppercase, not in lowercase. There is a format, right, which you have to follow. If you are writing, see here how they written. Label also. C capital, L or small. Everywhere you just notice how they written. Certain standards you have to follow when you are writing. Okay. Don't put unnecessarily underscores here and there, and however you like to practice, don't do it. And when you are practicing also, don't use your name. It's not like some Ramesh calendar or Lakshman's calendar. Not like that. Use some company name. Okay, use some company name, you will feel really something else. What generally we feel if you just practice with your own name, okay, that makes some difference also. You will just thinking and you will be getting into some kind of organization related transaction process. That's how you will be start working. So don't use your name when you are practicing. Okay, use some company name, and whatever you try, just with, try with some companies. When you are getting supplier or customers, something else, don't use your friends' names as suppliers or customers. Use some real companies what you see in the market. Okay, that's how, please do the practice, that will help us. Okay, done. Description. You can see here, description, this field is optional. Already discussed, the white color fields we call as optional fields. It's not mandatory, we have to enter the data. Okay, so you may provide some description, okay, to add some detail, I mean, to which where it can talk about which calendar it's all about and what is the, for which country you are creating. You may provide some descriptive information, okay, for more information about this definition. I'll just write HCL accounting calendar for India. I'll put here accounting calendar for India, just I'll mention 13, means with the 13 periods I'm creating. Of course, when you look into this, we can understand, but let's keep in that, keep the same in the description also, nothing wrong. It will be good information for anyone. If somebody is going to look into that, they can easily understand. Done. Here, whatever you are not going to discuss now, you don't focus on that. I'll be covering each and everything. I'll be covering each and everything. See here, you have enable security. Please don't ask me what is enable security. That is separate feature. And here we have some square bracket kind of thing, boxes. Those are separate features. We have everything. We are going to cover everything. What we should learn from this application to gain good knowledge and to work in the any organization. Okay, I'll be covering each and everything, but you don't start focusing on what I am not discussing. I request you to focus on what we are discussing, and you can ask me a number of questions on that, no issues. Okay, I'll be happy to answer for any question. Fine. Now we'll see what is the title here we have? Periods. That means here we have to provide the period related information. Okay, we are going to create the calendar for India. What is the financial year for India?
April.
Financial year, April to March. So the first period should be
April.
First period should be April. In the period name called as April, if you have to take prefix. Prefix means initial characters. What is the best? What name you can take as a prefix? Short name, simply APR. So here the same we have to enter. See here, periods, prefix. So for April, you can write APR. Okay. Here when you're writing the name, you can write as APR in capital or else caps or else PR. A capital and PR. But generally, just you can go in this practice since that is a short name. The full name will follow that format and all. Since it's a very short name prefix, you can write it as a APR in uppercase only. Don't practice with the lowercase and all. Okay, done. Now here, what is the next period? See here, map with this periods type. Period type. Just now we created, right? Just now we created period type. So we created period type. That period type we have to select. Why we have to select, we will be understanding now. First we will see how to, first we will select it, then we will discuss about it. Okay. If you want to select that period type, if you know the name, what you can do is simply you can type here. I'll type HCL, tab out, use tab to move to the next field. Okay. And the fly system will fetch that value from the database and it will get selected into this field. See here, I am using tab, it will get selected. If you have period types, many period types with this, which starts with HCL, it will filter and it will give only those names. It will filter and it will give only those names which are starting with HCL, but now we have only one period type, so it's directly selecting. This is one way you can select. Other way is, here we have one simple representation which we call as LOV. LOV. LOV stands for list of values. Make a note. You have to use the same terminologies and all. Okay. Don't use click on this, click on that. What is this? What is that? We should know. Okay. Say LOV. You have to click on LOV. LOV stands for list of values. What is the meaning of list of values? It will contain the values which it can display in the list. Okay, it will list out. It will display. Okay. Fine, done. So now what we can do is So now you can type if you know the name and tab out. Okay. If you type the partial name, you have to tab out. Otherwise, even just if you can type the full name, if you tab out, it will be fetching if the values existed. If I type something, if I tab out, nothing. It will display what all are existed because nothing is matching. So it cannot filter. Only we have to select here existed period type. Okay. Fine. So here I'll be selecting HCL. Done. And year. What is the current financial year? Tell me. What is the current financial year? 2016 to 17. This is, there is integration. I mean, the current financial year, every financial year will have a integration, right? So here it got an integration from 16 to 17. So current financial year starting with April 2016, going to end in the March 2017. That means 17 is going to be reporting year for us, right? Yes. For current financial year, 2017 is going to be reporting year. Here, year means reporting year we have to mention. It's not like we are in present in which year. Okay. But since for India financial year is April to March. So always the reporting year we have to take as a year in this field. If you are creating the calendar for US, which year we have to take? Current year only 2016, because it starts Jan, it ends in the December. In which year you are in the same year, we have to current year we have to select as a year. But when you talk about physical year, okay, if you are going to create the calendar for physical year type of with the physical year type, definitely you should go with the reporting year only. Here you should not select up to December 2016 from March Jan. You should not select 2017. For the entire financial year, you have to select only reporting year. So which year we have to give? 2017. April will fall into which quarter? April falls into first quarter. First period definitely in first quarter, right? First quarter. So how many, I mean, this for this period, what number you want to give? Just it's all about sequence. We will be counting. It's going to be first period, right? Okay. This period is belongs to falling under first quarter, and this period is going to be first period in our accounting calendar. Done. Now tell me, like, when this April starts and when this April ends as per current financial year or any financial year. Okay. Any financial year, it's not going to be changed financial year to financial year generally. When it starts. Why I said in the current financial year means you will be just taking the year. That is the reason I mentioned. Yeah. First April 2016 ends. 31st not. That's what I said. This period I asked. Yeah. I didn't ask for year. I asked for period. When April starts and ends. I'm not asking when financial year starts and ends with the dates. Okay. So it starts. Basically, first means 01, the format wise, iPhone. So, not 04, here, see, for every instance, we have a preference to choose the date format. Very standard format generally we use is, we don't put 04. Yes, some companies you can see they'll be using, nothing wrong. But the very standard format would be, you can write APR. iPhone 2016. This is how you have to write, system will accept. Okay, but instead of writing this much detail level, you can write in short, system can convert that into the standard format, which is selected for this instance. For every instance, you can go with that. If you go, when you are working, you may see the date format as a 2016, as you said. Somewhere you may see, like year will, month will be first, right? This is all about their preference, how they want to, just how they want to choose the dates and all. So that depends, we have a preference to choose it, okay? But this is generally, this is a format we use, okay? Most of the cases, okay, done. This is how you have to enter. Okay, if you don't want to enter this much detail level, in short you can enter. What you can do is, instead of entering 01, enter 1. I don't want to enter hyphen also, then enter APR. I don't want to enter 2016, I don't want to enter, give hyphen 2016, just I'll give system. System can understand our work, what we are trying to do. Okay, then it will convert this into actual format of the date. Just tap out, it will convert, done. So when you are just doing it, doing this way, you don't need to enter each and everything detail level. And you see, if you click on this LOV, it will open the calendar. Again, that is big task. You have to go and you have to select, etc., etc. You can see here, we are in September. We are creating for April. Click up or down or here and there, it's a big task. So always just enter like this. 30th, APR, 16, done. Okay, that's how in the short you can enter the date, it will convert into standard format. Fine, now you tell me, system is taking the name, right? I didn't give any name, right? You didn't give any name, but system is taking the name. You tell me how it is taking based on our definition. It is taking prefix. It is copying the prefix, and from the reporting year, it is copying suffix. 2017, 17 it is taking. That's how it is creating. So do you think whatever system created, it's a right?
Right
or wrong?
Right.
Don't say system created means right, or we created means wrong, right? We should not take in that way. System is doing means it may not be right also sometimes. That's how the function may work, but generally nobody will develop system to do something wrong. Okay, but there will be cases where there will be some logic which cannot be managed that should be done by user only. So here, think and tell me, don't tell me simple answer. Think and tell me this, whatever we create and whatever system taken, right or wrong?
Right.
Right. Who are right? Wrong. Who are right? There should be proper explanation. It's not like a right or wrong, two values only, one value, let's choose. Who is right? Who are very sure? Why tell me?
Such name is APR, sir.
Hmm.
Any year is 2017.
Hmm.
That is taken
APR 17. Taken. Why it is taken? Those are there, it is taken. Why it is taken?
The account is ending
period.
No,
come on. See here, what is the from date and to date? For this date range, can you give the name as a April 2017? No. We given there. I agree with you. I am not saying we didn't give it is taken. We given, I am asking the question. For this date range, can you keep the name as April 2017? No? Yes? Yes? Which country you can see this kind of logic? April 2017 should have which date range? First, April 2017 to 30th April 2017, right? But here, it's matching or conflict? Come on, what's wrong here? Year. For this date range, here, period name should be?
16.
Ah, 16, that's what I'm trying to get from you. Right? It should be?
16.
Why taken 17? No, it is taken from reporting, that is the reason it taken. But we have to correct it. In that case, it will take correct. It will take correct. It will keep that year only, right? It will take that only. In case of when you are creating the calendar for normal year, calendar year, it will take and will accept. But in case of physical, it will take based on the values which you are inputting at the time of definition. But we should know as a consultant what it has to take, what it should not take. Okay. But don't think in Oracle apps it will happen like this in all the cases. Only this is the case which you see where you have to correct it. Okay. So this is the point we have to understand. Yeah, financially, when will be closing the books? 2017, right? That we call it the reporting year.
No, we got it also.
Sorry?
16,
April 16, last financial year.
Last financial year,
reporting happened already in last March.
right? For current financial year, closing will be in the next year only. So that is the reason, okay, we'll take that as a reporting year. If you are going to create next financial year, there will be given 2018. That's it. Okay, done. But this April, we have to record the transaction from the first period, right? So it should be 16. From when it can be 17? That's it. Done. We created one period. In the same way, we have to create the other periods also. Okay, we have to create the other periods also. Let's do it. How many periods we plan to create?
13.
Where you mentioned? Period type. If I am going to create 20 periods, is there any issue?
No.
No issue. You may say that, but there is issue in the system. System won't allow us. The reason is, within this period type, whenever you select this period type, system will be looking whether these guys are entering within the 13 or more than 13. If you are trying to enter 14th period, gives a message saying that you have a permission to enter max
13.
For that control purpose only, we are using the period type. Okay, let's see that. Sorry?
Can we edit the period type?
You tell me, can we edit or not? Already class is over, I explained also. Can we edit or not? Oh, I'm sorry if you didn't attend. So we cannot edit. We can change the name, we can change. We can change the name if at all, if you write description, you may change it. The number of periods, periods per year and year type. These two parameters you cannot change. Once you create and save it, the fields will be grayed out, freezed. So you cannot do the changes. If at all you want to go with something else, create new period type, use in your accounting calendar. However you require in your accounting calendar, in that way only you will be creating it. But think general point, we never do that. We'll plan and we'll do it. It's not like you felt something and you created later, you felt different thing, you are going to change it. It won't happen in that way. It's a fixed and you have to take decision as per which country are. Period types in the sense all about number of periods. We'll speak to the client how many adjusting periods they require as per the require. We'll explain them what is the purpose and all whatever we discuss, and accordingly we'll define it. Generally there won't be any need of changing. That's it. Okay, done. Now we'll create the second period. Okay, May. And same period type, right? Same period type. You can type HCL, tab out, or else click on LOV. You can select it. Okay, instead of typing and selecting, we have a shortcut. So the same value we have to copy into current field, right? The same value we have to copy into current field. To copy the same above field value to current field, you can use the shortcut as a shift F5. Hold shift and press F5. Shift F5. Okay, if you use this shortcut, what system will do? The above field data will be copied into current field. Current field, above field data will be copied into current field. See, shift F5, copied, done. That's what we need, right? For our entire calendar periods, we need the same period type. So now here also, what we'll do? Shift F5. For quarter also, shift F5 or one, which is easy?
One.
One only. That's what I asked that question. Shift F5, two actions, right?
Yes.
Okay, one. And for this?
Two.
See here, say I'm trying to create period, 14th period. Of course, this is not exact sequence, just for information, okay, to understand. I'll try to create 14th one. See what system, how system will react. Tab out. Please enter a period number between 1 and 13. How come system know? Because we told to the system, we informed to the system, we have a plan of creating max
13
that we given here. If you don't give this one, it system cannot give this message. You should give something else within that, how much limit you have, that only to understand. Okay, now anyway, as per sequence, it should be second period and say 1st May 16 and 31st May 16. And period name should be
16.
May 16. Just use down arrow or else place the cursor in the next row. Anything you can do. Just use down arrow from keyboard. Okay, it will move to the next row. Here, same process. June. Shift F5. Copy. Shift F5. Quarter is which quarter?
One.
First quarter. First quarter only. Okay. So third period. 1st June 16. Ends with
30th June 16. The period name should be
16.
June 16 only. July. Take all these points, make a note. It's not like okay, he's doing okay, fine, he's creating properly, even I am able to understand properly, means it won't work. You have to go and do the practice, right? You have to practice in the system. You should not depend on other people's notes. Okay, you should depend on your note only. So that is the reason. Please make a note each and every point. Okay, make a note. How your note should be means if somebody is missing today. Okay, you should be able to give your note to him to understand everything what class happened. Please make a note in that way. Take all the points, please. Okay, here shift F5. Shift F5. Quarter is second quarter, right? Fourth period starts with 1st July 16, ends with 31st July 16. I'm sorry, here I went wrong. And period name should be July 16. The next period is August. Shift F5. Shift F5. And second quarter, fifth period, and starts with 1st August 16, ends with 31st August 16. August 16, it should be. Okay. Then September, shift F5, just copy. This is also falls into second quarter, and period is going to be 6th period. It starts with 1st September 16, ends with 30th September 16. The period name should be September 16, not September 17, as system is taken. Okay, then next period is October. Copy the same period type. Okay, 17. See, since you are going to practice, don't go with the different your own practices. You will create 2-3 period types. Okay, anyway, within the calendar, we'll be using the different periods for your satisfaction purpose. Okay, please don't do it. Only for one calendar, use one period type only. Not required in any case. Okay, fine. Third, it's going to be 7th. 1st, October 16th, ends with 31st, October 16th. And period name should be October 16th. The next period is November, shift F5, shift F5, third quarter, 8th period, starts with 1st November 16, ends with 30th November 16. It's going to be November 16th only period name. Then December, copy the same period type and reporting year, quarter is third quarter. 9th period starts with 1st December 16, ends with 31st December 16, and it should be December 16. Now next period, because we created 9 only, we plan to create 13. Standard periods are 12. One we plan for adjusting period to record the adjustment transactions in the year end when you are closing the books, right? So John, period type is same, still reporting year same only, right? Up to March same, same, and it's going to be fourth quarter. It's going to fall into fourth quarter. Period number should be 10 and starts with the 1st John 17, right? We enter into 17, the definition done. It will end 31st John 17. The period name now we have to change to
John 17.
We don't need to change, right? Okay, we don't need to change it. We have to accept because system, now its system is right. Right, done. Feb, copy, shift F5, copy. Quarter is 4th, period is 11th, and starts with 1st, Feb 17, ends with 28th, Feb 17. Period name is correct, we don't need to change it. Go to next, March. So same, okay, fourth quarter, period number is 12th period. And here, 1st March 17, 31st. 17. And period name should be same. Then we created standard 12 period since we choose the period type as monthly, right? Then now we'll go and create the adjusting period. Okay, so fine. So let's give the name anyway. Adjustments and all we'll do in the year end. Year end means it's going to be March only. Give the name like this. ADJ, or I'll say March. ADJ. Adjustment. Short name. Adjustment. Because when you see that name, you should be able to understand it, right? Okay, so just mention that. So same, you can copy the period type, you can copy the same year. And period, reality, it's not belongs to any period, quarter, right? But since we are going to have for adjustment, that should fall into, that should relate to four only, fourth quarter. So that is the reason you can take into four. You can think reality is a dummy. Okay, dummy in the sense for the purpose is different. We have a different purpose. Why we maintain. Okay, so period number should be 13th period. And when it should start, when it end, different practices companies can follow. So you can take to pass your adjustment entries in between 1st April to 31st April, sorry, March, I'm sorry, March, 1st March to 31st March, or else they may opt this adjustment period only for last week of the month. Any practice we can follow here, just for our practice, our testing, what we can do is we can go with the entire date range for that period, so that there will be chance where you can record the transaction adjusting period from 1st March to 31st March. At any point of time you can record it. Okay, so to again, I don't need to enter, we have a practice above shift field. If you want to copy, shift F5,
shift
F5, done. Okay, now you can save it. How to save? Here we have a save icon, or else you can use a standard key called as control S. Just I'm clicking on this save. See what system is saved. Because I'm not going at where I forgot and all something, just to give you some better understanding, I'm trying to do these kind of things. What system is saying? Only adjusting periods can overlap with the another accounting period. What is the meaning? System is not able to understand and is giving some message. Well, something is repeating in the definition, but if that is adjusting period, yeah, that can be repeated. The dates can be repeated, but here I don't see anything as a adjusting period. The system is saying, system is not able to find adjusting, but we given adjusting, right? We return, right? But that we can understand. System cannot understand. System cannot understand. System will understand only with the functions or the programming, how they return. So in this scenario, what you have, if you create adjusting period, it's a mandatory. You have to select that period as adjusting. You have to enable the checkbox. See here, adjusting. If you are creating any period for any, all the periods, you have a option to choose adjusting. That means we don't choose for everything, but which period is adjusting, we have to mark it. So now you create it, just you have to enable it. Now if you try to save, it will accept. System will understand, okay, good. The periods, the dates are repeating, overlapping, because those dates are belongs to adjusting. Yes, adjusting periods can be, in adjusting periods, the same dates can be repeated, can overlap. On that base it will be taken. Clear, right? So when you create any, if you have adjusting periods, you have to add. You have to enable this checkbox. Otherwise, you cannot proceed further. You cannot complete the definitions. Okay, done. Now you can save, it will accept. See, once you save it, what system is doing? It is freezing. Of course, name it is freezing. Description is always open to change. And rest of all fields are open. Only period type. You cannot change the period type. That is a fixed. That's all. You cannot change. That means no chance in future if you want to increase the periods. You cannot do it. That is the reason when you are creating the calendar only, you have to have a double check with the client by explaining how the period type adjusting periods can be used. You don't need to speak to them, okay, you need 12 standard periods or 13. Nobody will ask this question. Always that is fixed. No one can decide. That is fixed, we have to follow. But only the point is,
how many adjusting periods they require, whether they need adjusting period in the end of the year or else they need one in the first period and one in the last period, or else quarterly ones they need some adjusting periods. That's how we have to speak. I will discuss detail level. We have one concept called as translation. But there is some purpose and all we'll discuss. Just I'm giving the point. There is a concept called as translation. If you are going to do the translation you cannot do in the first period. What is our first period in our calendar?
April.
That means in April month, if you want to do the concept called as translation, okay, we'll understand detail level. Just I'm giving the point. If you want to do the translation activity in our system, we cannot do it for first period. If system is not allowing, how? As per business, we have to do it, right? System should support for the business process, right? We should not, nobody follow to do the business as per system. So because it should support for that, what Oracle saying is there is some limitation, but what Oracle says is if you want to do the translation in the first period, better what you can do is you go with the one more adjusting period. You take first period as adjusting period, your actual period will become as per system count second one. System won't allow for first period, but it will allow for second period. For system, that is second. For us, that only first. The first one we given for system to overcome that limitation. That's how we'll be doing. We'll discuss when you're working on the detail level. Just as a point I'm giving, why we have to really require those adjusting one case is to do this kind of, to do some adjustment transaction. Other reason is translation we cannot do in the first period. For that reason, we require what translation, in which scenario, how it works, everything we'll discuss. Okay, done. We created and we saved. Now, simple question. When you are working in the company, if you perform some work, okay, if you perform some work, what you will do? After you, so you are working as a employee, everybody will be having the managers or supervisors. Once you do some work, what you will do?
You have to submit to manager.
Every work will be submitting?
Manager.
May not be. Which is really required. Okay, which work the managers has to review, that only, right? Everything you may not submit. Okay, everything you may not submit. Okay, even it's a part of your profile, everything. Which is required, really required. Okay, our manager approvals or review, whatever, that will be submitting. Okay, why you will be submitting? Because the manager know better than you. That is a simple reason. Okay, manager know better than you, and there will be some many other reasons also. That is the reason. So when you do some work in the organization, which is very important, that definitely that should be reviewed and validated. Then only that can be taken into next step. The same in the system also. Which manager will be having in the office? Tell me some manager names, not exact names, the role names. A process manager, sales manager, purchasing manager, etc., etc. So based on the relevant function, they will be taking care of the process, etc., right? The same way, however, we have sales and purchasing, etc., etc., managers in our office. Okay, in the same, in the system also we have one manager. Okay, system also we have one manager. That manager we call as concurrent manager. Just make a note. Okay, in our application we have one manager called as concurrent manager. System, we have a manager called as
concurrent
manager. What is the job of this concurrent manager? Why the concurrent manager is required? Why managers are required in office?
To validate.
Primarily to validate. Simple term you can use, validate. It means lot. Okay. The same in the system also, when we are working, okay, when you are working, to validate what we are doing, this concurrent manager is required. Now we created a calendar, right? Is there any guarantee you know exactly which period starts and on which date which ends in the what is the exactly start date and end date for each and every period? May not be. Out of 100, 2, 3 people may not be aware of, right? They, when they define July 1st and 31st, August they may give 30th, right? In February case also, there are many concerns, so they'll be giving their own periods also, their dates also. But yes, you are, as a consultant, you are entering, but system should look after that. The concurrent manager knows better than everyone, because Oracle written the programming like that. The Oracle told to the concurrent manager, okay, this is what, how it should be and all. If you do something, that work we have to submit to concurrent manager will validate. If something is wrong with that,
Concurrent manager is a very angry means will get error. Otherwise, warning only will be get. Warning means it can be corrected. Error means you are totally wrong. Or something wrong with the system also sometimes. That's how we'll be getting the message from concurrent manager. Anyway, we'll see that. But simple point I want to tell you. When you do some work in the system, that will be submitted to concurrent manager for validation. Once that is validated proper, then only that can be used in the business process application. Okay. We are not going to submit everything which are key tasks, which are key activities which we do in the system. Those should be submitted. There will be very few only, but not everything. So now we created accounting calendar. What we have to do, this accounting calendar we have to submit to
concurrent
manager. Let's see how to do it. Simple. Already we created and we saved, right? Now whenever you try to close it, system will ask us, do you want to submit your calendar or else all the calendars which are in the system, which you prefer to submit?
Only the
our calendar only, right? So we'll submit, then it will go to the manager. When manager is validating, you can go and see the validation process also, not in the flow diagrams and all, just the representation you can see as it is getting processed. Then finally you can see the status also. If everything fine, it will be normally the process request will be completed. Otherwise we'll get some error or warning. We'll see that. Okay, done. Clear, right? Do you have any doubts in this? And one more very important point I want to add here is, so we done, say we are in the March 2017. Think this period is March 2017. Now you require a calendar for next year also, right? Then what you have to do is, you don't need to go and create one more. You don't need to go and create one more calendar. You can create within that for next year also. But we have periods up to
13.
13 for 1 year. If you start with the next year, again starts from 1. Okay, it starts from 1. It will accept up to 13, right? Then the next year we'll be creating. How you'll be creating? Just I'll give you a few records here. So again, you say
April,
APR, same. And for this, what should be reporting here? 2018. And first quarter, first period, first April 17 ends with 30th April 17. Should be 17 done. Go to next page. Hope you can do it. When you are testing in the lab also, what you can do? Create minimum calendar for 2 years, just for ever practice purpose, testing purpose. Create for 2 years minimum. Okay. So this is how we have to do. We don't need to create every year separate calendars. The same calendar definition will be adding the
next year.
Years in the sense year periods. Year periods. Okay. That is a practice will be followed. Okay. Now done. Now I'm in the current. Just I opened one more record, right? If I open one more record, if I try to save it, the form cannot be closed. I mean, sorry, not saving. If I trying to save, of course, in this case, it won't get saved. I cannot close the form also. If you go to new record in this way, if you want to clear that record, you can use F6. Take the shortcut. Okay, if you just go to any record, in the record, if you find the fields are mandatory, without entering the test, you cannot save it as well as you cannot close it also. Very few forms will allow you to close also, but most of the forms won't allow. Okay. So in that case, how to come out of the form? You want to exit from the form, but it won't accept. In that case, you have to remove that record, whatever you opened by placing the cursor. For that, use F6. The record will be, space will be removed. Okay. Not only empty record will be removed, even if you have data also, the data existed record also you can remove by using F6. I'll use F6 so that record will be cleared. Anyway, just for testing we created for next year, right? That's not required. I'll use F6. This entire record will be removed. Done. Now you can change it once again if required. We didn't do any changes. We just pass some values and we remove. Done. Okay. Clear, right? Done. So we created our accounting calendar for current financial year. Okay. Okay. Done. Basically this, when you are creating calendars and all, when you are working, we don't enter in this way very manually. We'll be using the data loader. We have some tool which we call as data loader. The data loader will input the data and that will be loading. Okay. So you may think there we have to enter, we have to load. Instead of entering there, you can enter here, right? There are reasons. Okay, that we'll be discussing when you talk about
real-time classes. There I'll be covering how to load this calendars data into system through data loader. That will I'll demonstrate. You can understand. Okay. And why we have to load with that, if what is the advantages also will be discussed. Okay. Done. Now we created. Now what we have to? I'm trying to exit from the form. Just click on close. Now it will ask the confirmation from you how you want to proceed. Do you want to validate currently displayed calendars or all your calendars? Say current. Once you click on current, the request will be submitted to Concrete Manager. The request ID also you can see. You no need to make a note. Directly you can go to the some window where the all the requests will get processed. So once I click on current, okay, as soon as I click on that, immediately it will complete the process. So how to go to that form, the navigation I'll give you, but quickly I'll go to that form so that you can see as the process is running. Click on current and click on okay, then go to this form. I'll show you the navigation later. Here, see, you can see system is running on request. We call as request means we submitted this calendar to Concrete Manager. So that is the reason we call as request. What is the request? Which request we submitted?
Calendar
validation. Request we submitted. Now Concrete Manager is working. Phase is pending. The under process and normal. Now here, simple point I'll ask you. You submitted something for your manager to review and to get back to you. You submitted today. You asked to complete to reply back to you by today. If manager is not completed, think like manager is not complete by end of the day. What you will do? You'll go and hit the manager, right? Hitting in the sense just it's you'll go and talk to the manager, right? You say just I submitted yesterday, please. Okay, there is some urgency, etc. In the same way, once again, if you go and ask, there is a possibility where the manager can complete the task, right? Immediately, that validation or what approvals, whatever. Otherwise, you submitted, you are roaming here and there in cap area, you are going ahead with the work, etc. Manager also may be busy with his work and it may be get delayed. So what we have to do? We have to hit the manager. Okay. So here also in the system also, you can hit the Concrete Manager by clicking on refresh data so that this manager also will become very active to complete your work. Okay. So it's not required all the time. Generally, the system will complete, but it takes own time. But if you hit, immediately it will be complete. So that is the reason you may click on refresh data, then it will be complete. Don't think I clicked on refresh data, immediately it is completed, but it's lying with that status. Even if you close and open also, you can see the status as completed. Okay, but generally if you submit something, it takes some time depending on the object which you are working. In that case, always what you can do is, anyway, you should come to this screen to see the status. You can just click on refresh, though that can be complete as soon as possible so that you can go ahead with your practice. If something is going to depend on this. Okay. And now here you can see the status. Normal. If something wrong, it will give the warning. Or everything totally wrong means error. But generally in calendar case, we don't get errors. Okay. If you create in your own way, you may get it. Okay. But generally we don't get it. Fine. So that is the thing. If you see warning or anything, what is the reason also you can see here. If you want to see, say for example, you created a calendar. Unfortunately, you found warning. In that case, you can click on view output. Okay, you can click on view output. There you can see the detailed reason why you got the warning. The reasons you can find here based on the reason. The reason may be you use the same date in another period, or else what you did is you forgot to specify. You forgot to give 30. I mean, you given 30th instead of 31st. You thought like only 30 days. But actually that should be 31. The system will identify, manager, Concrete Manager knows very well. Okay. So that is the reason that can be identified. So whatever the Concrete Manager says to us, or whatever the system or say Concrete Manager says to us, that you can find by clicking on view output. You can click on view output. The output file will be open. Now you don't find anything as something wrong. See here, system is saying the following periods have a date gap. Date gap means if I give April month, March as a 1 to 30th, here it will be showing gap start date as a 31st, gap end date also 31st, one day only. Starting and ending same, it will be giving. If I forget, if I take March 25th, up to 25th only, 1st to 25th, it will give the message date gap is 26th to 31st. Okay, March, that's how it will be giving. Here one more we have here. Okay, overlap. Means the same date if you are going to take in the another. So I created a period as a
1st March to 31st March. When I'm going to create April also, there I started 31st March to 30th April. I should give from 1st April, right? But I taken from previous period also one date. That is overlap, repetition. In that case, it will be given the message which days are overlapped and all. Based on that, you can go and open the your accounting calendar. Okay, anytime you can do the modifications, but don't think that is the best practice or generally we do it. There should not be some issue if you create the calendar. That's how the minimum we should be okay with that, right? You should know how to create the basic thing of calendar. Okay, but we have option to correct it if something goes wrong. Okay, done. That's it. Okay, this calendar creation and all is a one-time job. Once a company start using, there should not be any plans to change the calendar, etc. Again, that falls into separate project also. Okay, it won't become simple task to simply go and change, since system will allow you to create, but you cannot take into the synchronization of existing data and all those things. That is the reason this is a very kind of one-time task where we have to take proper decision. Of course, it's not like only number of periods adjusting company can take, rest of things everyone has to follow whatever the however the year starts and all to say financial years. Okay, done. So that's all about accounting calendar creation. Done. We're done with accounting calendar. Now we'll see currency part. Okay, accounting calendar is ready. We can use it, but when we can use it, we can take into part of primary ledger creation, then we can use in the transaction process also. Any doubts or questions? Okay, I forgot to tell you that. Okay. So now basically from anywhere, you may open the form or you may be directly on the navigator to go to that form where you can see the concurrent manager, whatever the request concurrent manager is running, okay, processing, and to see the status, take the navigation, go to view, request, okay, view, request. Now simply you want to find that status of the request to whatever you submitted, right? For that simply you can click on find. We'll talk about this form. There are a few other points also you have to understand that we'll see later. For now, just you have to navigate to the right. Just click on find. That's it. We'll be landing on that form. Okay, navigation is again view, request, click on find. Okay. Now let's try to understand what we call this form. This form we call as where we can see the request whatever you submitted. SRS form. Just make a note. SRS. Stands for standard request submission. SRS stands for standard request submission. SRS form we call simply. When you submit some request, we'll go to SRS form to see the status of request. That's it. From this SRS form, you can submit some request, even you can generate the reports also. Okay, any report you can generate from here. Any upcoming sessions, we'll see all those. Okay, done. That's all about this calendar part. And based on that, you can create the calendar for US. If required for US or any country, you can create it, right? That's it. Only in case of physical, this is how you have to manage up to December. From there, it will be 17 only. And other than that, if you are creating for US calendar year, then generally just the same. John, and yeah, you'll take the period type. You'll give the reporting year as the same year. If you are creating for current year only as a reporting year. Rest of things remain same. No changes. And only the focus is how many adjusting periods they require. We'll talk to them. We'll explain purpose. Then they'll come up with their need. And as a consultant also, we have to suggest. Generally, minimum we should suggest one. And if they are going with the translation also, if they are going to have in their business, okay, we'll be suggesting to have one in the first. That's it. Okay, done. So see, when you are working as a consultant, it's not like they will ask, we'll give or we'll tell. You have to understand product thoroughly. Then once you are into project, you can understand. You'll get a chance of understanding their business detail level. Then what best future is available, what best way we can give the solution as per their business process, you should analyze and you have to come up with the best, better suggestions, and they can opt it, they can be happy. Otherwise, when you are doing implementation, they may be happy by thinking, yes, implementation is going on. Once implementation done, they'll be very sad. So as a consultant, our role should be, we should give good consulting, good business solutions. When you can give and you are okay with this product, you should understand first thoroughly, or else you are going and doing practice, you are learning in the sense, okay, they will learn. You should not give the project to this company or something else. Okay, so that's how, because that's the reason I'm telling all those points, everything you have to spend time, take each and every point, read thoroughly, and sit and have a discussion with others and give the presentation. To do all those things, you have to invest a lot of time. For that reason, I'm telling, spend time in the institute only. Okay, however you go to office, however you spend in the same way, please come here by 9, spend till up to 5 or 6, your favorite hours you can choose and you can exit from here. Okay, but you should spend more time, that's it. That should be your target. Otherwise, if you do some this course and all, nobody is going to come to us to invite. Okay, you should be okay with the subject. That is only the big point which you have to understand. Done. Now we'll talk about calendar. Okay. So we discussed already currencies. We'll talk about currencies. We have three type of currencies. Those are functional currency, foreign currency, stock currency, and how the things works, etc., etc., what base and all we discussed. Now calendar we are creating as per our requirement, right? But when you talk about currency, yeah, please.
How can you make the changes?
Simple, just go to the same form and you can change it. That's it. See here.
Setup,
financials,
calendars,
accounting. Okay. You know how to find it, right?
Yes.
Type HCL. Then say, like, by mistake you given July as a 30th only. That's what the content manager reported you. And you click on output file. Now what you can do, if it is a 30th, think this is how you have, you found the mistake as one day is missing in this July month, just come here and correct it, save it. First time, see here I saved, now I will try to close it. Okay, so again system is triggering, because some changes we did concrete manager identified. Okay, so click on correct, again it will be submitted. If that is only the issue, you won't get any warning. One more issue you have anyway. First time itself you can see and you can correct accordingly. But don't expect you will be doing the mistakes, or somebody will be doing mistakes when they are creating the accounting calendar. Okay, done. So now we'll talk about currency. We have different type, but whatever it may be, the currency, any currency, it can be functional, or foreign, or stat, whatever. So what practice we have to follow here, we'll see. So calendar we created as per our requirement, chart of accounts also we'll create as per our requirement. But when I talk about currencies, you no need to create any currencies. You no need to create any currencies. All country currencies are available in the system. All country currencies are available in the system. That means for which countries this product can be used as a business solution, for all the countries Oracle is providing the currencies. For most of all the countries, this product can be used. Because this is a global product. Okay. So that is the reason all currencies are available as a part of our instance. When you buy the instance from Oracle, any environment, it can be vision instance. Of course, vision in the sense with the sample data, not only vision, any instance. Generally, we call it fresh instance. Okay. In the fresh or anything, or once you buy the product, within that product, by default, you can see all the currencies. Along with the product, if you are getting such kind of information, okay, what type of information? Currencies. Along with the instance, if you are getting some information, okay, by default, that kind of data, currencies, just I am referring as the data. The currencies information simply you can call as seeded data. Seeded data. Seeded. I can say a simple statement, all currencies information will be available in the system as a seeded data. Seeded means fundamental, basic, which comes with the product, default. Okay, seeded data. Which you find in the instance, along with the product,
which you are not creating, which Oracle is giving, those information you can call as seeded data. If you are referring particular value, simply you can say seeded value. Simple, I'll tell you, when you are creating the period type, you have two types, right? Physical year and calendar year types. Those two are who created? We?
No.
Oracle created. Those are there as a fundamental data within that. Those two values you can say seeded values. That means which are coming along with the product, which we cannot create, which should be created by Oracle, because behind that they will be linking with the programming, coding. If somebody is selected as a physical, this system has to behave like this. If somebody is selected as a calendar type, this should behave something else. That's how they will be writing. Now we selected physical year type. I mean, we selected period type, right? The period type, we have year type as physical. Because that is a physical, that is the reason system is copying the prefix and suffix of year name. If you go with the other, that's how they written the program. If you go with the calendar, it won't copy. Okay. I mean, just example I'm telling, that's why it is copying, in the sense they written if based on the value which they selected. Okay, so that's how the functionality will be there. So for certain cases, but not everything. But simple point, what we have to understand, if anything you are finding within the instance which you didn't create, or somebody or other consultant is not, other consultant is created, other than that, entire data which comes with the product we call as seeded data. Specific value means simply we call as seeded value. That's it. Okay. So done. Now what you have to do is, by default all currencies will be part of instance. So which currencies you require for your client when you are doing implementation, which currencies
we require
for the client related business process? Primarily the local currency they require, right? Apart from that, client may not do business in the different countries, but they will have a customers and suppliers from the different countries also. That means primarily their functional currency, their country local currency, plus in which other currencies they will have a transactions. In other countries they may not do business literally by having some operations, but even there they may run the operations from one country with the different customers and vendors. In that case they have to record the transaction in the foreign currency, right?
Yes.
So what functional currency they need as per their local currency, and apart from that, what are the foreign currencies also client require? All those currencies just we have to enable. What we have to do?
Enable.
We have to enable. We don't need to create. Don't start creating. Just we have to go and enable, because all currencies are available. If you want to create, system will allow, but you don't allow yourself. Okay, not required. That's a bad practice if you are going to create the currencies, even for your practice purpose. Okay, we never create any currency. Okay, if there is going to be new country, in that case, Oracle will be adding in the next version. Okay, if you are standing on this version, okay, that Oracle will release in the next version, but in this version it won't be there. In that case, you have to add it. Let new country come, you can do it. Okay, so till that time, new country means new currency will come, right? Till that time, you should not do anything in this. So let's see how to enable the currency. Now take the task as
enable
currency. Okay, application is GL only. Again, you don't need to make a note. Only you have to take the navigation. The short name you can take NAV. Okay, task name is enable currency navigation. We'll see the navigation. Take the navigation. Setup currencies. Not that kind of arrow, this arrow mark. If setup currencies, just double click on currencies, and we are going to
define.
See function. The function name they given to define. Reality we don't need to define. All are defined by Oracle only. We don't need to define. But if you want to enable also, we have to go with that form only. Why they given define? If at all you want to add new currencies which are not existed in this, those you can create from here. The naming convention they given defined, but all the time the practice what we do is enabling them. If you don't enable here, what happens? When you are creating the primary ledger, what we need? Calendar we need, currency we need, chart of accounts, accounting method. If you don't enable, say for example INR you are not going to enable, when you are going to create the primary ledger, which currency you have to choose? INR only. We need INR means the same will be choosing. So it won't be available there. If enable,
then only that will be available to create the primary ledger. If that is available, then only you can record the transaction. For the amount, you can give the specification as a currency. The balance or belongs to INR. That is the reason it's mandatory you have to enable. Okay. Okay, you may not enable immediately, but before you go and create primary ledger, you should enable it. Okay, you may enable it after creating the chart of accounts also. But in the sequence, just I am taking as a currency as a second step. Okay, done. So navigation is setup, currencies defined. Okay. Let me do this. Done. So double click. Now if you want to find what are the currency required, all currency will be there. Simply what you can do, you can go with the find, right? Just type INR, IN, it will fetching. There is no other currency which starts with IN. So INR it's selected, done. Okay. So here you can see, if you have to scroll little right. Okay, you can see the currency code, unique code for country, INR, currency code. INR stands for Indian Rupee. And issuing territory, yes, India only. And precision means if you enter one rupee dot, after dot two decimals will be getting. That is a precision we are calling.
Precision.
Yeah. If you keep three, if you enter one rupee dot three digits, three zeros. If you have some paisas, etc., that conversion will happen on that page. Okay. So that's how we have. Okay. So extended precision, like you up to what level you can just extend it to max and all, you can set it up. Okay. Just finally what we have to do, you have to by default, when you are working in the fresh environment, no currency you see as enabled. All will be in the disabled mode. Which currencies you require, you have to
enable.
Just enable and save it. That's it. Okay, we have to enable and save, but in our lab, you don't find the currency is not enabled. We'll be finding almost the currencies are enabled, because by default many currencies are enabled within the vision. For practice purpose, our people will be enabling and all. When you are practicing, you just navigate to that. Since we are learning, navigate to that and verify. Even you are very sure enabled already, but go and see that, so that will be some knowledge or understanding or experience for us. Okay, done. That's all. Okay, fine. Now just earlier we discussed, when you create the period type, we discussed a few points, how to query, right? How to query, or else how to find, or how to take the navigation to query, those points we discussed. And the other point here I want to talk about, so I want to see all currencies which are created in this form. If you want to see specific record, what you have to do, you can go with the query mode as we discussed already, right? F11 to keep the form in the query mode. You want to query the currency called as INR. So there is nothing else. So that is the reason I am not keeping percentage, right? Just only the value is INR only. How to execute the query? Control F11. Then the record will be fetched from database. Now my requirement is, I want to see all the currencies in this. Of course, I can see all the currencies if I click on find, right? The list will come. But my requirement is, I want to see all in this screen, all in this form. Simple. You are keeping the form in the query mode and you are asking the database to display only one record, right? You go with the query mode F11 and you don't ask the database to display specific record, ask for all. Don't give anything in that. Control F11, all will be fetched. Any form, even period type also, you can open. You want to see all the period types, then keep the form in the query mode with the F11, right? Then execute the query by using Control F11, you will get all the records. Another option is, from any form, if you want to export the data also, you can export it. These are the currencies, I want to export this data. So in that case, I can say export. So just you can place the currency in the first record field, and you can go to file, say export. All these currencies will be exported to Excel. This function is applicable almost many forms, not every form, because in all the forms will be having tabs and all, some that would be tough to the system to fetch for under tabs also. You can fetch easily from database. Okay, that will be in the very formatted manner, but this kind of plain forms where you will be having without tabs and all, you can fetch the data. 100 records fetched, 100 more records fetched, yes.
seems to there is some error in this, I think in this MS Office download it's not working. Okay, no issues, but it can be exported. You try in the lab, it will work. Because I am accessing the system through remote desktop, and the remote desktop seems to there is some issue with the Excel and all. Okay, you can export, you can say all the data in the spreadsheet. That's it. Okay, done. So that's how it works. Okay. So this is all about currencies, what we have to understand. Which currency we require, simply you can enable it. But next, what is the next task?
Chart of
accounts. Okay, before we go on, we already discussed how the chart of accounts structure, right, how we can create and all those points we discussed. Before we start with the chart of accounts, we'll try to understand few points. Then when you are creating, you can be more confident and easily you can understand. You may look for other point to understand. Okay, since that is very, very important. Okay, so here I'll go with the chart of accounts. Fine. So here, let me use this point. Here what we'll do is, okay, I'll take you through simple points. Just make a note, and why I'm going to share that information before you defining, you should remember these points since they are very, very important. But once we start working on the system, I'll be explaining those very detailed. Now I'll just introduce to you, you will be able to answer what is that purpose and all. It takes some time, because in the same time if I am explaining, that will be big confusion for you. Whenever you find the time, really you can understand, that is the time where you have to understand. That will be in the effective of the process and all. I'll be explaining it a little. Okay, for now just I'll give you some points and make a note. The simple point here I'm just giving this all, whatever I'm going to talk about that related to chart of accounts. Okay, but you don't need to keep as a title as chart of accounts, not required. So here say my statement is, we have two type of qualifiers. Make a note. We have two type of qualifiers. Okay. We have two type of qualifiers. Those two type of qualifiers are, one is flex field qualifiers. Other qualifiers are segment qualifiers. Okay, we have two type of qualifiers. Don't try to understand which color these qualifiers will be. Okay, I'm not expecting from you. Only my expectation is, without meaning you will remember before we go and get the meaning. That's it. Okay, we have two type of qualifiers. One is flex field qualifiers and other one is segment qualifiers. And how many flex field qualifiers we have and segment qualifiers, we'll see now. The flex field qualifiers, we have 6 flex field qualifiers. And when I talk about segment qualifiers, we have 5. Just make a note and remember, that's it. Okay. Okay, we have two type of qualifiers. Those are flex field and segment qualifiers. How many flex field qualifiers we have?
Six.
Segment qualifiers are?
Five.
Now we'll see, what are those 6 flex field qualifiers? Okay, we'll see what are those 6 flex field qualifiers. Just make a note. The first one is balancing segment flex field qualifier. You don't need to call with the lengthy names and all, we have short name also that we'll be discussing. Okay, but for now you can take like this. Balancing segment flex field qualifier, not qualifiers. Qualifiers we have, within that this is the one, so qualifier only. Then natural account segment flex field qualifier. Third one is cost center segment, cost center, paste it,
cost center segment flex fill qualifier. The fourth one is, okay, so don't think this is the exact sequence. So we have six, you can keep in any sequence, okay, which are important, which are optional, that we'll discuss detail level, but in the just in one sequence I'm giving.
Okay,
don't say always first one is balancing one. Okay, there is no that kind of rule. Okay, intercompany segment flex fill qualifier. And the fifth one, I can say secondary tracking segment flex fill qualifier. Fifth one is management segment flex fill qualifier. Okay. We have six flex fill qualifiers. Six flex fill qualifiers, those are balancing segment flex fill qualifier, natural account segment flex fill qualifier, cost center, intercompany, secondary tracking, and management segment. Simply, you can say what are the six flex fill qualifiers: balancing, natural account, cost center, intercompany, secondary tracking, and management segment flex fill qualifier. You respect last one, just read out complete, so that would be good. Done. Okay, this is a list. Okay, we'll talk about it little bit more later. First we'll see what are those five segment qualifiers also. Those are, say, allow posting, allow budgeting, account type, third party, control account, reconcile. These five we call as segment qualifiers. Okay, sorry, no, just what are those five you have to understand. Okay, which is the first, which is second, that is not there. Total five you have to know, that's it. First, second, third, no, there is no rule like that. When we are creating the chart of account, we have some sequence, right? That kind of sequence we don't have. Those are six, these are five, you should know, that is enough. What purpose we have to understand, that's it. Okay, done. So fine, we have a six flex fill qualifiers and five segment qualifiers. Okay, done. This is one point. Okay, we'll touch all those what we are discussing again to understand some other points. And other point is, when we are creating the chart of accounts, within the chart of accounts, what we can have?
Segment.
Structure as a part of chart of accounts, we'll have a structure name under the segments. For each segment, we'll have a segment value. So that means the segments will be part of chart of accounts.
Yes.
Right? Part of chart of accounts. Now take the point, we can create max 30 segments in the chart of accounts. Okay. How many segments you can create? Max 30. Can create max 30 segments in chart of accounts. Done. Okay, maximum you can create, but if at all you are going to use the chart of accounts for your company, there should be minimum rule also, right? There should be rule saying that minimum these many required. The same way, to create the chart of accounts, you can create the chart of account max 30, but to create the chart of accounts, minimum two segments are required. Without two, you cannot. It won't work. You may create, it won't work. Minimum
two
segments are required. I'll give you what are those two. But is one is for sure always same, but second one can be changed on what base and all will be understanding. For now you can take these two names only. You treat for now temporarily these two only, but 99% those two only. There is a 1% chance where one will be switched to some other also. That also will discuss why and all, that also will be understanding. Okay. Those two minimum segments are company and account. Okay, when you are creating the chart of accounts, max we can create 30 segments. But to create, to have a chart of accounts minimum, there should be
two segments.
That means you can say two segments are mandatory to create the chart of accounts. You can say two segments are mandatory to create the chart of accounts. What those are?
Company
and department. So temporary naming convention, we are giving company and account. Later, once we understand one point, we'll be renaming it. We'll be calling with a different name. That remain as company and account only. Okay. If not company, it can be branch or something else. We'll discuss. But these naming conventions will be changed. We'll see that. Okay, done. Fine. So minimum. Why they are given minimum these two and two? Because every transaction, minimum for every transaction, there should be opportunity to identify the transaction belongs to
which company
minimum. May not be which department. Or else which branch or which location or which product or which project, etc., etc. Minimum, this transaction has happened in
which company, which organization.
And which transaction happened, the transaction activity, which activity happened, that has to be tracked with the account. That is the reason account also exists. So always we'll be mapping, always we have to understand the sum. Each and every business transaction will refer some account. So event or activity or transaction we may call. So that should belongs to some company. This is a very, very basic information to maintain any books of records. Okay. So that is the reason these two are mandatory. Done. Now the simple point here. Now again, we'll go back to this. Okay. Don't try to understand something else. The same point you take and remember. I'm not expecting from you, you'll be understanding these days, not required. Once you get into that one by one, it will be more clear and clear. You can get 100% understanding out of that. Okay. So here a simple point I am going to say, and before that I want to give you the structure. What we'll do, if you want to create the chart of account, we'll create the organization structure. Okay, organization structure, which will be the group, company name or entire structure name. Okay, that's just the title, name only. Under that we'll have a segments, under segments, for each segment we'll have a values. In between something else also we'll be having, that we'll discuss when you are doing practicing the system. I'll explain you and I'll be adding. For now, this is what I try to understand. Very prime level. We'll have organization structure, under organization structure, segments, under segments, segment values. All these put together we call as chart of accounts. Chart of accounts. Now the simple point is, we have here two type of qualifiers, right? Flex field qualifiers and segment qualifiers. Your simple understanding is, the flex field qualifiers will assign to segments. Just make a note. Why we discuss and understand later. But now the simple point is, the flex field qualifiers we assign to
segments.
The flex field qualifiers will assign to segments. What are the other qualifiers we have? You can guess and tell me that can be assigned to anything. Only two options are left.
Values.
Okay. Values is the correct answer. You can say organization structure also, because we didn't discuss, right? So, but this is for values. Segment qualifiers. Okay. So two type of qualifiers we have. We discussed how many flex field qualifiers, six, and segment qualifiers are five. Those six flex field qualifiers can be assigned to
segments,
and five segment qualifiers we can assign to
values.
The purpose we'll understand later. First we have to come up with this terminology and how it can be assigned where and all. And then it's understanding that concept will become easy for us. Okay, done. Now the same I am going to keep here. Okay, fine. Anyway, here also you can say this flex field qualifies to
segments.
Assigned to segments. The same I am writing once again here. This stage. It is to segment values. Okay, flex field qualifiers will be assigned to segments and the segment qualifiers to segment values. Now, other point and important point is how many flex field qualifiers we have?
Six.
Tell me what is the meaning of qualifiers? It's general English term meaning I'm asking. I'm not talking about Oracle apps. What is the meaning
marks
of qualifier?
18 marks are there. You have to qualify that 18 marks.
Yeah, same. So qualification, we know the qualification, right? Okay, in terms of referring some object, we call as qualifier, right? So if you get some qualification, what is the advantage?
We have the knowledge.
You know the subject.
Chance. You know the knowledge or not. If you get some qualification, what is the advantage I am asking? He will be qualified for certain jobs. Or he will be qualified in a certain process. Or you may see nowadays, the respect to qualified people will be having different behaviors also.
Yes.
That should not be, but we can find. See, qualification should not give different behavior, right? Okay. Fine, anyway, that leave it. Okay, if somebody is qualified, they can get some privileges. The guy who has a minimum bachelor degree, they can apply for this job. To apply for so-and-so job, minimum master degree. Or else if you give an attempt to some test and all, if you get qualified, you can go with some course or some overseas education, etc. Many things are there, right? That's it. So that means if somebody is getting qualified, they are getting some rights. And you can find the people, they'll be having some behavior also. Based on I did something else. This is you find it. But I'm not talking about everyone, just you find some people. Okay. So if you take that real life example, that means the qualification the person is getting different behavior. Here, why I am talking about people behavior, not to in the negative way, to explain here in the proper way. Okay, that is the reason I am taking that point. So that means if somebody qualified, they are getting some rights and they are getting some kind of behavior. The same way, once you assign any qualifier to segment, the segment will start behaving in a different way. The segment will start behaving in different way and the segment will have some rights also. Okay, that is the meaning of qualifier in the system. Okay, that is the meaning of qualifier in the system. We have to understand. Simple point is, the qualifier, if you assign the qualifier to segment, the segment will get some behavior, okay, different behavior. Maybe you did your CA or something else, your confidence levels will be different. You can think, okay, anywhere I can go and get job. And I compare it to this MBA or MCOM, other guys, I'm better than always, I'll be on top of, I'll be, that, I'm just referring that, kind of confidence or their behavior, etc. The same way, based on which qualifier you are assigning to which segment, accordingly the segments will start behaving in the system environment. What purpose, we'll discuss in the next step. Okay, so fine. How many flex field qualifiers we have?
Six
we have. So out of six, two are mandatory. We have third one also, it's a mandatory, but by following some condition that we'll discuss detail level. But primarily those two are these balancing and natural. Just make a note. The balancing and natural account segment flex field qualifiers are mandatory. It's very powerful, these two are. Okay. Mandatory. Okay, out of six flex field qualifiers, two flex field qualifiers are mandatory. What are those?
Balancing
and natural account segment flex field qualifiers. Now the balancing segment flex field qualifier will assign to this. We have to assign to what?
Segment.
That's what we discussed. Yes. The balancing segment flex field qualifier will assign to company. Segments. Which segment means I am saying company. 99%, 1% is left, that we'll discuss about it. What would be that scope? And natural account segment flex field qualifier will assign to account. That is only the left. Account. Okay. So we have six flex field qualifiers. Out of that, two are mandatory. Balancing and natural account segment flex field qualifier. The balancing segment flex field qualifier we have to assign to
company.
The natural account will assign to
account
segment. Now simple question. If you are qualified some degree, you will be called as, or else 10 people qualified their degree. The group of people can be, or specific person can be called as
qualifier.
Bachelor degree qualifiers.
Bachelor.
Okay, fine. The same way that based on qualification, okay, so we can say these are the bachelor degree holders, these are the master degree holders, these are something else. We can, based on their qualification also, we'll be giving some naming, right? To just identification purpose, right? So based on qualification, you will put some name for them. Okay. Okay, these all are bachelors. Means bachelor degree holders. Okay, these are masters, these guys did. That's how users simply you can classify so that easily you can understand who are bachelor degree, master degree and that. How they are called in that way? Because of their qualification. Now the simple question is, if this segment is assigned to this, this segment will be qualified with this, right? Somebody will get degree, they will be qualified with it. The same way, if you assign this balancing segment flex field qualifier to company will be qualified as a balancing segment flex field with this qualifier, it will be qualified. And if you assign natural account segment flex field qualifier with account, this also will be qualified with that respective, what we are assigning. So, now instead of calling, if you do degree, bachelor degree, your name will remain. Here also company and account will name will remain, but you are getting some additional naming, identification as a bachelor degree holder. The same way, once you assign this qualifier with this, in short name, the company can be called as what? Tell me anyone.
Company balancing segment.
Company ignore it. Tell me in another way.
Balancing segment.
That's it. Now company you can call as balancing segment. Why? For company segment, we assign the balancing segment flex field qualifier. That is the reason. Now company you can say
balancing
segment. Now what you call this account, what you call
natural
account segment, add it. Okay, so natural account segment. Now this balancing and natural account segment flex field qualifiers, we are assigning the two segments. Okay, and simple point is, to which segment you assign balancing segment flex field qualifier, that segment will be called as, no secret, not difficult. To which segment we assign, that already we discussed, same I am asking. To which segment we assign balancing segment flex field qualifier, that segment is called as?
Balancing.
To which segment we are assigning the natural account segment flex field qualifier, the segment is called as? Over, game is over. Okay, but always we assign natural account segment flex field qualifier to account only. But when you talk about balancing, 99% company, 1% or 2-3%, what else we'll be discussing in further sessions when you talk about project based discussions and all. Okay, done. Now I'll ask the question, tell me right answer. Okay, please don't tell me old answers. See, in chart of accounts, we can have maximum 30 segments and a minimum
two
segments. What are those minimum two segments?
Balance.
That's what. So if somebody is going to ask you answer in that way, they'll find you are the experienced guy. If you say company and natural account, you don't have experience.
to create the chart of accounts, we need two segments. Those are balancing and the natural account. That means to assign balancing segment, there should be one segment. To assign natural account, there should be another segment. Finally, two, since these two are assigning, these two qualifiers were assigning the same names, you can call those segments. Now your answer is, if I ask you how many minimum segments you have to create, two. What are those means?
Balancing
and the natural account. Which is your balancing segment, I may ask you? In that case, you have to say company's balancing segment, which is natural account means that within that we have answer account done. Okay, the balancing segment can be your company or sometimes something else, your line of business or something else. Department generally we don't take, and it can be your branch, some operational area or some business area or unit, etc., etc. The simple point, we will go detail level later, but to give you some basic idea. So what level the company wants to balance their business transaction to have a financial reporting and all. What level they want to track the expenses, or the, they want to find out their revenues, and what level they want to have a data security or transaction process, that level they will be choosing as a balancing segment. Say simple example, if they have 10 branches, definitely each branch level they have to identify how much they are incurring the expense, how much they are getting the revenue, final how much profit, and each and every data department, I mean branch wise, that has to be secured, and branch wise only they will have a operations transactions, right? If some company has a 10 branches, simple point, 10 branches they will be taking as a 10 balancing segment values. Segment they can take as a branch. Under that segment values will be branch names, will be segment values. Generally instead of branch we call as company. Under company those are nothing but branches only, but company may be same, branches can be different. That's how we'll discuss detail level when we talk about multi-arm structure. Okay, for now this is a simple point to understand. Clear, right? So maximum how many?
30.
Minimum 2. So maximum Oracle giving 30, but other side what Oracle is saying is don't use many. Okay. Don't use
many.
If you use, go with many segments, since Oracle is giving, that will become very poor practice of your implementation. What happens is, if you have more number of segments in your chart of accounts, more number of chart of accounts, there will be many performance related issues. As a product capability, they're given 30, okay, but you don't see outside somewhere somebody will be using more than 10. You see somewhere you have to think about it. Why they are using. There may be many good reasons, but many segments is always is not best practice or best solution for any company. What you have to do is, max you should try to minimize. You should try to minimize. Even you are minimizing, there should be best outcome for the business based on the chart of accounts which you are designing. There are many parameters, okay, there are many factors which we have to take into consideration when we are designing the chart of accounts. Now we are in the very initial stage. If you start with that, I don't find half of the members tomorrow in my class. So that is the reason I'm not going to talk about it. We'll find the time and we'll discuss about it. So today we'll try to understand what we have as a part of chart of accounts, how to create without knowing too much. Basic level, I'll tell you, the phase by phase will be understanding. By the time you complete the course, everything will be touching. If something is missing, make a note and let me know. Ask me then and there, no issues. Okay, so let's see how and what process is the best to learn and to touch all these points. We'll go in that way. Now we'll see how to create, then we'll try to understand when you start with that in real time when you are doing the implementation, how we'll be creating and all. There is a concept called multi-arg. At the time I'll explain detail level, we'll be doing the complete stuff in the system. I'm not going to show you already which are already configured when you are working in the real time. So in the fresh environment, from where we'll be starting, what need to be done as a functional consultant for finance, everything we'll be doing. It's not going to be just I'll be presenting something. This is how it can be done. See, already Oracle did. We don't need to do it. I'm not going to do that kind of task. So you are alone. You can go and you'll be able to do the implementation. I can take care of up to that level of knowledge. Okay. So that is the point you have to understand. Max 30 we have, but Oracle recommends minimum. If you go with many segments, there'll be performance issues in the system. The reason is the chart of accounts which you are creating, that can be used across all the applications. Your payables will be using, receivables will be using and all here and there. Simple point, if the company is going to have a hundreds or thousands of Oracle users, they'll be using
from here, from payable somebody will be accessing, from receivable somebody will be accessing, from there, here and all the ways people will be accessing. And if it has a lot of weightage of multiple segments, how it will, the performance slow. The chart of accounts cannot travel within the applications across or etc. You can understand in that way. So that is the reason. It's all about, it will create some performance issues. And there are some performance issues. There are some solutions also from Oracle. I'm not saying there are no solutions, but recommendation from Oracle is better you can go with a less number of segments. That is always. And again, you just come up with the best solution as per business requirement. If some implementation is going to be success or failure, if it's going to be success or fail, only the key factor is chart of accounts. The best chart of accounts will always will give the best results from this ERP product. You have a bad chart of accounts, but you did everything, but no use. You can say implementation failed. So that is that much key factor. Okay, chart of account design and all. We'll discuss more on this. But for now, just these are the simple points for our understanding. Okay, fine, done. So that's what normal practices you can see companies will be using. 7 or 8 or 6, maybe 9. Okay, if you see 10, it's a very lengthy chart of accounts only, we have to say. Okay, but normal, now general practice, you can see on an average 6 or 7, something like that. And again, there will be some future, etc. I'll talk about it. We'll have a detailed discussion on that. For now, it's not required. We'll proceed with that. Clear, right, these points?
Yes.
Done. Okay, the other point. Okay, other point I want to give you here is, we have 5 type of accounts. Okay, we have
five
type of accounts. So what are those? Let's see. We know very well. Expense. Revenue. Tell me other. Assets.
Ownership.
The shareholders, equity and all. Okay, which you find as a net income and all, that can be classified as a ownership account type, stakeholders. Okay, these are the 5 type of accounts we have. Okay, fine. It's a simple, like you know, like what is the expense, means whatever you incur that comes under expense. When you do some sales and all, you'll get revenue. And what are the current or fixed assets that comes under assets, and whatever you have to pay, that is a liability, your net income and all, the company profits, okay, that we call as ownership related. Just simple, just remember, we are not going to do anything with this now. The further system practice, this all we'll see, so that it will be easy. All will be like, once you start doing the chart of account configuration, okay, you can answer to me, like I can ask you, okay, this what we have to assign to what, you can answer. Okay, you'll be knowing everything. It will be easy for you to understand. There itself, you can think on something else to ask some questions. Okay, so 5 type of accounts we have. Okay, here when you look into these segment qualifiers, out of these segment qualifiers, you have account type, right? Those only 5. Now just we listed, right? Those 5 account types are part of segment qualifiers. Within the segment qualifiers, we have one qualifier called as
Account type.
Within that, we have 5 type of accounts. That's all. Okay. Other point. Okay. Just make a note. We have 2 type of flex fields. we have two type of flex fix. The one is key flex fields, okay, one is key flex field and second one is descriptive flex fields. Okay, key flex fields and
descriptive
flex fields. Those two key flex two flex fields, key flex field and descriptive flex field. What is the last term we have? Field.
Fields.
That means those are fields only in the application. If you open some form, what we see?
Fields.
Fields. I'll open some form which is unknown for us for now, but just for discussion, let me recorrect this. Time out. One second, let me re-log in. For 2-3 classes completely we can ignore this operations user, we can forget about it. We'll be working with the our own users for now. We'll see based on this. Okay, that's it. So we have a descriptive flex fields and
key
flex fields, right? Means DFF and KFF. DFF means key flex field, DFF means descriptive. We have two type of flex fields, those are KFF and DFF. We didn't discuss about this form, but just for information I'm just opening this. So these all we call as fields, right? Because these all fields Oracle given. These all fields Oracle given. Apart from that, we may need some additional fields as per business process and all. For example, see simple point I'll tell you. I want to, when I'm recording the transaction, I want to enter the company, I want to enter account, I want to enter department, I want to enter location, I want to enter some product, I want to enter project, the cost or something, revenue or belongs to which project and all. I want to enter where I can enter in this form. Generally, this is a form which we use to record the business transaction, but I don't see somewhere where I can give that information. I want to give the company, department, account, location, product, project, some line of business, etc., etc. Means that information is very essential as per my business process for reporting or internal management, manager reporting or external reporting for anything. I need that information. This is a form Oracle is providing. Okay, Oracle is providing to record the transaction. Where I can give? No field. No field Oracle given. But Oracle giving one option, what you can do is, what information, what details, apart from the fields, whatever Oracle is giving the form, apart from those fields, what are the detail additional information? Additional information means key information as per your business process, as per standard process, which is really required. That kind of data, if you want to capture, what Oracle says is that information That information you can keep in this key flex field. I want to capture company, department, account, location, all right? So that those directly I cannot see in the form. What you can do is all those information you can keep in the key flex field. See, that company, department, account, location means out of the total business information, that is key information, right? So the key information of the company keep in the key flex field. Okay, key information. Because in every transaction that is required, every transaction you have to capture company, department, account, location, etc. Okay, done. So that is the reason I am calling it as
key
information. Where you can maintain that key information?
Key
in key flex field. Key flex field. The same way, there may be need to capture some additional information only in specific activity or specific business process on particular application related processes. See, if you take tables, there can be many activities which you'll be doing. But just when you are creating invoice, you may want to capture some additional information where Oracle is not providing the fields. That means that is additional information, right? So additional information means not mandatory all the time, not compulsory, key information, right? That kind of additional information you can maintain with the help of descriptive flex field, so that with the help of descriptive flex field you can capture that additional information. In other words, you can say optional information. If it is optional, why we have to capture? Maybe as per their process it may be mandatory, required. As per standard business it may not be required, optional. That means when you are recording the transactions, okay, say for example in GL or any other application, whatever the fields Oracle is providing, apart from that, there will be need of capturing some key information. In every transaction, key information is required, right? But when you talk about additional information, in specific transactions, some additional information you may want to capture since fields are not available, so standard fields are not available, okay? So that means the key information you can maintain by using the key flex field. In key flex field, to maintain the key information, we have a different key flex fields. Okay, we have
different
key flex fields. But take key flex field. Again, this key flex field for each and every application will be finding different. I'm going to talk about key flex field which are in GL. GL, yeah. So in GL we have a three key flex fields. Those are accounting key flex field. I'm just KFF means key flex field, right? Okay. And GL ledger key flex field. And reporting. Reporting attribute key flex field. Say name as a otherwise GL key flex field. GL, how many key flex fields we have?
Three.
Three we have means we have a three different key data. Okay, we'll discuss detail. I'll just take this point. GL, we have a three key flex fields. What is the purpose of key flex field? With the help of key flex fields, we can maintain the company key information. Mandatory, compulsory. That is a mandatory. Without that, we cannot create any transaction. That's it. So that kind of data, to maintain that in GL, we have three key flex fields. Out of three, these you may use, may not use. There is no issues. These are not mandatory. But the mandatory key flex field in the GL is
accounting
key flex field. Make a note. GL we have three. Out of three, mandatory key flex field is accounting key flex field. So accounting key flexible, in key flexible you maintain the key information. Simple question, what is the key information you find when you are recording the transaction?
Date, amount,
transaction,
description. Anyway, date, calendar we have, currency, amount, we are, currency we are enabling for amounts. Apart from that, very key is, apart from those two, description. If you want to capture description, there are no fields in the form. Just now I opened, right?
Yes.
You find some fields?
No.
No. But what you can do is, what information you want to capture, that information you can create as a segment. Company segment, maintain company balance, department, maintain as a department. Account, location, etc. You maintain all those information. You'll be creating as a what? Chart of accounts, right? With all the information, you'll create the chart of account. That chart of account you can create within the accounting key flexibility only. Remember, okay? We can create the chart of accounts with the help of accounting key flexibility, not key flexibility. There is a separate name that is accounting key flexibility. Okay, with the help of accounting key flex field, what we can do?
We can create
and maintain our chart of accounts. Once our chart of account is there as a part of accounting flex field, what system will do is, in every form, wherever you enter the transaction, wherever accounting is required, within your chart of accounts, so what are the segments we have, what are the segment values we have, all it will display in the forms. See here, I'll go here. This is a form which where we create journal. But if you create chart of accounts, within the chart of you have segments and segment values, right? If you go to this single field, whatever they're given, what are the segments and segment values you have in your chart of account, which is created within the, please answer, within the, just now we are discussing the same.
Accounting key
flex field. Okay, when you're recording the transaction, what are the segment and segment values you have as a part of your chart of accounts? Okay, and which is created in
accounting
key flex field. That information will be displayed in this field. You see here, if I click on this, it's displaying company, department, account, sub accountant to product. That means already Oracle created this. Already Oracle created. Their chart of account name is this. Operations accounting flex. In that they have these segments. Under those segments, these are the segment values they have. That's it. Okay. So this form we are able to access from this field. Okay. From this field we are accessing these values which are in chart of account. The chart of account is created in accounting key flex field. That means simple point, by using accounting key flex field we can create and maintain our chart of account, so that that will facilitate us to track the detail description of the transaction. Done. Okay. So that is all about, that is the meaning of, that is the use of key flex field. We have two more, this got some different purpose, not important. Anyway, we'll touch that, or we'll touch when you are working detail level and the GL when you are working, I'll explain you what purpose Oracle given, but primary is that only. You may not use the remaining. Okay, we'll discuss about it. Okay. The simple point to understand to key flex field purpose is to capture the key information of the organization. Here one of the key flex field is accounting key flex field. Within that we are made in the chart of account. Okay, done. Now other point is, along with this key information you can track from here. Apart from key, you want to capture some other additional information also. For that we can use descriptive flex field. Okay, descriptive flex field you can see in the form level. See here in the square bracket, if you see something that is a descriptive flex field only. However, you can have a segments in our chart of accounts the same way. However, we have we'll create the structure, segments and all. In the same way, for a descriptive flex field also, you can create the structures based on which data you want to capture at the time of transaction. See, I'll place the cursor here. If this descriptive flex field is enabled, it will open some fields. It's not enabled. If you want to capture additional information this level, you have to enable. And there you can create the segments and the segment values, what we call as the attributes. That we'll discuss detail level. Okay, or else you are creating the an account here, by using that you will be entering the amounts. You want to capture some additional information. See, these also are descriptive flex. Wherever you see in the square bracket, all are descriptive flex field. Through that you can capture some information. My requirement is, so this, my requirement is, who is, this is journal. This journal is entering, who is entering automatically system will capture. That I'll show you where we can see. But my requirement is, system has to capture which user is entering this journal and this user, who is user supervisor. Okay, or else the person who is entering the system will be capturing. Okay, here there will be help within that. If you go here, record history, it will be displaying. But now we didn't create anything, so it won't display anything. It will be capturing. Apart from that, the user who is working, the this user supervisor system has to capture. So in that case, I'll be listing out all the supervisors, the DFF descriptive flex field, the descriptive flex field. I want to use where? Journal form, right? I can say descriptive flex field name is journal descriptive flex field. Again, this is the header, this is the lines. Journal line descriptive flex field, journal header descriptive flex field. This is how we'll be having. Those we can use to capture some additional information, which may not be really mandatory, but as per our process required, you can use it. That we'll discuss detail level. If I go in depth, it may become a bit confusion for you. Okay, so to conclude this point, okay, two type of flex fields we have, key flex fields and descriptive flex fields. Key flex field always will use to capture the key information of the organization, and descriptive flex field to capture some additional information. Really some information is required, they'll be adding, otherwise it can be optional. Sometimes they'll be keeping the field. If required, they'll be entering, otherwise even the field is there, they can ignore. Means where we can make the field as optional also, we can make it. The additional information field we can make mandatory or optional, that you can do. If you go with example of key flex fields, the key flex fields are, just make a note, specific to application. These are application specific. These are application specific. If you have some key flex field, okay, that will be, that can be used within the application only. That can be used within
application.
One application only. That means key flex fields are specific to application. And descriptive flex fields are specific to form. Those are limited to form only. If you go and enable some DFF, descriptive flex field, to capture some information, that DFF you can see only in that form. You don't see other form. Other forms will be having separate DFFs. Okay. Sorry? So descriptive flex fields are specific to form. Or say function. Descriptive flex fields are specific to form or function. That means if you set any DFF for any form, when you go to that form, then only you can see. If you go to other form, there you don't see that. But when you say application, key flex fields, specifics are application. But few flex fields are, key flex fields are, can be used across all the application. Best example is key flex field. You create the key flex field, the ownership will be owned by GL only. This is owned by GL. The key flex fields, I mean these key flex fields, these three key flex fields are part of GL only. But within this chart of accounts we have, means chart of accounts required in all the application, right? This can be shared. But some other key flex fields we have, those cannot be shared anywhere. If you go to that application, there only you can see. If you exit from that application, you don't find anywhere. But our chart of account, the accounting key flex field is, okay, kind of flex field which can be shared across all the application, because that information is very key information. More we'll discuss on that in the next session, okay? So we'll come across. When you are creating, you can understand more, and I can add few more points, then it will be easy. Just I want to give the understanding. We'll create the chart of account. The chart of accounts will be creating by using accounting key flexifield. Accounting key flexifield comes under key flexifields. This is one of the key flexifield which is belongs to GL. The key flexifield purpose is capturing key information. Our chart of account is key information. Along with that, we have a descriptive flex fields also, which are not mandatory. You can ignore them, but you cannot ignore, and you can go ahead using the application, okay, account, I mean key flex fields. By ignoring the key flex fields, you cannot use the application, any application. But there are few key flex fields, even though are key flex fields, optional as per their business, where they are doing the business, etc. Okay, so key flex field is specific to application, you should use it. There are some cases, even that is a key flex field, you can ignore and you can proceed, but generally key flex fields are mandatory, okay, which are specific to application. Descriptive flex fields are specific to forms. Just 2 minutes, I'm coming. Okay, fine, done. So this is how we'll be creating. Now finally, our chart of accounts will be creating in accounting key flex field. Accounting key flex field is within the GL application. Okay, GL application. Okay, the tomorrow session, what we'll do is we'll start with the system. Okay, system chart of account creation. Before creating, I have a few more few more points to add to that. Then we can start, then you'll be able to see everything. Okay, we can complete chart of account creation and other points also we'll discuss that. If you have any doubts or queries or clarification you require, please ask. Okay, if not now, you can ask me tomorrow at least. Okay, but ask something, because that's what that says. Yes, you are really started thinking or understanding. I'm not saying you're not understanding, but just okay. So ask me tomorrow session if you don't have any question. Okay, fine, then see you tomorrow. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.